Welcome again, friends. In this video, we'll be talking about, here it is written, T cell activation. Now, when I mean T cell activation, I want to talk about both the type of T cell activation, which is cytotoxic T cell as well as T helper cell activation. So, let me tell you that T helper cell and cytotoxic T cell activation. Now, among these two type of cell, T helper and cytotoxic cell, we know that T helper cell can be activated directly by the direct contact with the MHC molecule. So usually T helper attached with MHC class 2 molecule and activate themselves, but T cytotoxic T cell can be activated directly with the attachment with MHC class 1 molecule. It can also be activated due to the activation or release of interleukins by T helper cells. So cytotoxic T cells can be activated using two different pathways, where T helper cells can be activated via one pathway. Okay, so we are going to see it here. So let's begin. So here we can see this is a APC or antigen presenting cell holding the nucleotide sequence, not nucleotide, peptide sequence here in green onto the surface of class 2 MHC molecule. Now here this antigen will be recognized by T helper cells. Now this is called T helper 1 cell. Now this T helper 1 cell will be attached to this MHC2 antigen complex with its T cell receptor, and again with this co-stimulatory molecules like CD24 and B7 and all these receptors, they will be attached and become activated. So the activation of T helper occurs always first, and after the activation of T helper with MHC2, so I am again emphasizing MHC2 in this case. Okay. So after this activation, it will start secreting some interleukin or chemokine molecules. You can see these interleukin molecules. So they will go and bind with the interleukin-2 receptor, which are found onto the surface of T helper cell. Now what we can see here, the auto activation of T helper 1 cell by the molecule interleukin-2 secreted by its own cell. This kind of auto activation, so let me write, it is called auto activation, right? So this kind of auto activation is called as autocrine activity. Autocrine, whether I don't know whether I spell it correctly or not, it's called the autocrine activity. Okay, and so that's how it is getting activated. Now once this T helper cell is getting activated, they can activate cytotoxic killer cells, cytotoxic T cells, and also other cells like. So as they are activating, so you can see more and more T helper cells are secreting this interleukin-2. They are going to act on themselves, and sooner what they produce is a pool of or population of T helper cells. So you can see population of T helper cells are generated after this particular step. So this is the process. After that, let's talk about the MHC one interaction with cytotoxic cell. Now let's say this is the cytotoxic cell. Remember, cytotoxic cell can be activated in two different ways, one by T helper, one by on its own. So if we look at the activation by on its own, so you can see here this is a cytotoxic T cell. It is attaching with this antigen presenting cell via the MHC1 antigen interaction with its T helper, T cell receptor, or TCR, as you can see here, and also with this co-stimulatory signal via the CD8 and other co-stimulatory molecule. After that, they recognize a signal. After this signal is recognized, it is becoming activated. Now this activated T cell can kill this particular cell which is activating it, right? So this is a one mode of interaction. Another mode of activation by this cell is due to the presence of T helper. Now we know that previous time T helper cell is becoming activated by the autocrine activation, but now this T helper cell can also secrete some important cytokines. Now the cytokines they are providing interleukin-2, they can also go and attach to some IL-2 receptor that are also present and found onto the surface of cytotoxic T cell. Now again, this activation of IL-2, which is secreted by other cell, here it is T helper, but acting on a different cell, which is TC. Now, secreting from one cell, activating on different type of cell, this type of activation is called paracrine activation. It is called a paracrine activation. I don't know whether I'm spelling it I or Y, whatever. It's called the paracrine activation, right? So these are the two different important part that we are going to see in this case. One is the autocrine, another one is the paracrine. So after this paracrine activation, the cytotoxic T cells are having the signal of proliferation and differentiation. They'll start making more and more CTLs. Sooner, we end up with many more cytotoxic T lymphocyte cells in this area. Okay, so that's how the T cells are activated, and I hope that's helpful. Thank you.